mushrooms have gotten a really bad rap. I think there's a notion that they're all toxic, which is not true. They've just been, I think, misunderstood and understudied. So I'm here to show and demonstrate there's a lot of beneficial fungi and mushrooms that can really help us with some of the environmental problems we're facing. I visited 7 brownfields and superfund sites of different types of contaminated sites in LA region and surveyed them to figure out what fungi and plants were growing there naturally and which ones were cleaning up the pollution that was found there. So from those 7 sites in that initial survey, I selected 3 to actually implement this study, testing these top fungi mushrooms and plant combinations to help clean up the soil on these sites, which all contain mixtures of a whole bunch of different common contaminants from lead, diesel, and different types of petrochemicals. Plants in nature pull up elements from the soil. They pull up nutrients from the soil. And that means that we can use those same abilities to pull up metals we don't want in the soil. Some of the fungi we worked with connect with plants and help them grow and take up more metals. And some of the other fungi we worked with eat dead stuff, mostly dead trees. But a lot of the petrochemicals and contaminants that show up on these sites are very similar to a dead tree. And so some of these decomposer fungi can actually eat it. The study ran for just 1 year, which is a really short time frame for bioremediation of these sites. And we saw really good results for all of the contaminants present. So for metals like lead, which are everywhere and really difficult to remove from soils once they're there, we saw that the plants, especially when they had these fungi added, were able to pull up and remove that lead from soils. There were a lot of other metals of concern like arsenic, cadmium, and hexavalent chromium that we also saw good results with these plants, especially with the fungi. We also saw amazing results in terms of the organic contaminants like diesel and petrochemicals and solvents. After the year period, these fungi had removed those organic contaminants from the soil almost completely. We witnessed so many co-benefits to not only this bioremediation approach as compared to conventional remediation, but also this approach that utilized native plants specifically and combinations of different plants and fungi and other amendments. So a lot of conventional remediation happens through excavating, so digging up all the contaminated soil and moving it to a contaminated soil landfill, typically out of state. It doesn't really solve the problem, right? It moves it somewhere else. Whereas these approaches, it's done in place, so you're not moving contaminated soil, you know, somewhere else. It's actually addressing the contamination. It's reducing all the emissions with hauling away that soil. It's building healthy soil in place. So a lot of these sites that have been bioremediated can, you know, go on to support parks or green spaces. And I would love for people to be able to see the transformation of these sites in such a short time. It goes from like, I can't even put a shovel in the soil, there's not a single worm, to, you know, there it's blooming with these beautiful native plants. The soil is rich and healthy. There's worms, there's pollinators coming. Now there's birds coming to the site. So there's just so many benefits to these approaches. We still need more field studies to demonstrate and make people comfortable with the effectiveness of mycoremediation or working with fungi to clean up pollution in the real scenarios where it's found. These studies in Los Angeles, they are some of the largest that have been done that included mycoremediation. And now what we're working on is scaling even further, taking what worked best and scaling that up. So hopefully there's a little more support and a little bit more awareness about the potential and the need and the many benefits to working with bioremediation for brownfields cleanup.